Hello everyone and welcome back to the Syntax UK YouTube channel. My name is Matt and today I'm going to be taking you through the remote fish controller from German manufacturer Ferrofish. On our channel recently we gave you an overview of the Pulse 16 series of AD-DA converters from Ferrofish. All three models that comprise the range offer a cost-effective way of expanding existing recording setups with additional high-quality analogue I/O. If you haven't already, make sure you check out the video by clicking the pop-out in this video. RemoteFish expands on the great control that these units already have by giving you remote control access to both the Pulse 16 and A32 series using a computer or laptop. In this video, I'm going to be having an in-depth look at the software, showing you some of the possibilities in terms of control that RemoteFish gives you. Access to RemoteFish is gained via MIDI or MIDI over MADI connection, or via USB on the A32 range. Once connection is made, RemoteFish will register your unit and show the serial number. Now this can be seen on the main page of RemoteFish here, so you can see my Pulse 16 MX shown here, along with the serial number. Now RemoteFish has no limitation on the number of devices that can be connected at any one time, which makes your computer or laptop a really powerful control hub when operating multiple Pulse 16s or A32s. So all your devices will be shown down the left-hand side, making it easy to identify the unit that is being controlled. On this page, you can also see an overview of settings for the device. Input channels are shown on top with the analog outputs underneath. There's some key status information available, showing that a lock has been made and that the device is getting power correctly. There is also sample rate and clocking info available, including the clocking source there in the top right. Headphone monitoring is also available here, and it's super simple to select the source that you wish to monitor. So if we wanted to monitor analog inputs 1 and 2, simply just select them here, and then there you go. The headphones port is now monitoring analog input 1 and 2. Now on the second page, there are controls for the input and output channels. This obviously allows you to adjust all input and output levels remotely. There's also a visual representation of all the levels, so it's easy to see which are running too hot. Next along the menus is routing. Now, as the name suggests, this gives you access to the routing matrix. From here, it's possible to route any of the inputs to any of the outputs. With so many different inputs and outputs available on even the basic Pulse 16 model, it's always handy to have the ability to see and adjust the routing on a larger screen like on a computer. Now, combined with the high number of Pulse 16 and A32 units that are controllable from RemoteFish, being able to switch between routings on each unit makes it much easier to configure a larger system of converters. The Pulse 16 range includes the ability to save and recall 6 presets. Now, these can be accessed from the preset menu here in RemoteFish. Saving a preset is as simple as pressing save on any of the 6 slots, and these can be recalled just as easily by pressing the corresponding load preset. Now, presets cover all the settings across the Pulse 16, including the channel routing. These presets are also saved to the device, not your computer. This means you can configure your unit with ease on a computer and recall it when needed again without RemoteFish. Finally, the settings section includes your device info. So here you can see the serial number as well as the firmware version and the capabilities of the device. Now, because I'm using the Pulse 16 MX, I've got ADAT and MADI connections at my disposal. If we were using a Pulse 16 DX, for instance, this would also show Dante under the capabilities. MIDI routing configures whether the device uses MIDI connections or MIDI over MADI, which is obviously only available for units with MADI capability. There are some other MADI options here. These include selecting 96 kHz sample rate for MADI, which reduces the MADI channel count to 32 channels in favor of the increased sample rate, as well as MADI short frame, which allows for compatibility with older MADI specification gear, which could only transmit 56 channels instead of 64. Now, as we mentioned in our previous Pulse 16 video, when using MADI, it's possible to daisy chain up to 4 Pulse 16 units. Now, delay compensation helps to indicate which unit goes where in the chain to compensate for any delay created. For instance, single means that only one unit is being used. 1 of 2 indicates that this device is the first in the chain of 2, and 2 of 2 makes it the second. So you can do this again for 3 units and for 4 units. Finally, there's just some handy controls here for your display brightness, and also one to remove the key click when using the controls on the front panel. That's it for this overview of RemoteFish, Ferrofish's remote control software for the Pulse 16 and A32 range of AD-DA converters. As always, please do make sure that you like this video and subscribe to our channel so you can keep up to date with all of our future content.